Hi guys, so we're back talking about conjugate acid-base equilibrium systems. So before we talk about acid-base specifically, we should discuss a little bit more about equilibrium, with which you should already be familiar, but a few pointers here so that we can get through the acid-base application. So remember that K sub C is the equilibrium expression, C meaning that it's based on concentrations as opposed to partial pressures. So K sub C, the equilibrium expression, is equal to the concentration of products over the concentration of reactants for the most basic reaction, where we just have reactants in equilibrium with products. Recalling that the double-headed arrow means the rate of the forward reaction is equal to the rate of the backward reaction. So when we have an equilibrium expression much, much greater than one, that means that the equilibrium lies to the right and our products are favored. And simple math will tell us that, right? If our numerator has a greater concentration than our denominator, then our Kc should be greater than one. On the other side of that is if our equilibrium expression is much, much less than one, then our equilibrium lies to the left and then our reactants are favored, right? If our denominator is greater than our numerator, then our value should be less than one. So let's make that a little more specific now for acid base. So remember that acid base involves proton transfer. Okay, so here then the proton transfer reactions can be thought of being governed by the ability of two bases to abstract a proton. Remember, an acid is a proton donor and a base is a proton acceptor. So here for our most generic example, we have HX denoting our acid, and here water acting as a base. Our double-headed arrow, where black indicates the forward direction and the blue arrow indicates the backwards direction. And we have our hydronium ion, H3O plus, as our conjugate acid, and X minus as our conjugate base. Okay, so in this case, because water is a stronger base than X minus, which here is just some generic acid, the equilibrium will lie to the right. Right, because the tendency here, if this is a strong base, is for water to extract this proton from HX and to make the hydronium ion and X minus. Okay, so if in fact X minus happens to be the stronger base, if it's stronger than water, then that means that the tendency would be for the back reaction to be favored, so that X minus would abstract a proton from the hydronium ion to make water and HX. And that would mean that the equilibrium would lie to the left. So in every acid-base reaction, the position of the equilibrium favors the transfer of the proton to the stronger base, as I just indicated in the last example. So then the equilibrium position favors the reaction of the stronger acid and the stronger base to form the weaker acid-base pair. So now it's time for a few pitfalls. So to solve these problems, you're going to need a chart available to reference the relative strengths of the conjugate acid-base pairs. You can find one of those very easily online or in a textbook. So here's a very simple example here where we have ammonium ion and hydroxide, which we know hydroxide is a strong base, forming an equilibrium with ammonium and water. So in this case, if you have a chart handy, you'll find out that hydroxide is a stronger base than is water. So that means that the tendency here is going to be for this hydroxide to abstract a proton from the ammonium ion to go forward and make the products NH3 and water. So since the forward reaction is what's favored, because in this case hydroxide is a stronger base, then the equilibrium will lie to the right, meaning that our products, right, are more favored than our reactants. And that's the simplest way to describe equilibrium systems in acid-base.